Hello students, welcome to IAS by Heart. We welcome you to the 13th session of the Prelims East Season 2. In this session, we are going to discuss 10 most probable questions that can be featured in your upcoming Prelims Examination 2021. As we told earlier, these questions have been modeled based on the previous years of UPSC question papers. So make sure that you are utilizing best out of it. Without delay, we are getting into the questions. The first question, the democratic system of government is formed on the basis of. So question from polity. So there are four options given. You have to find the correct option. Option A, civil liberties and political rights. Option B, political and economic justice. Option C, fundamental duties of the citizens. Option D, political participation and fraternity. So based on which of these following the democratic system of government is formed, that is the question. Okay, so if you go through the previous year's question papers, in the year 2020, there was a question from parliamentary system. A parliamentary system of government is one in which there were four options given. You have to find the correct options. Okay, so this question have been taken from very basic concepts from parliamentary system of government. So based on this question, we have formulated the democratic system of government, which has been clearly mentioned in our NCRT, the 11th standard NCRT, Indian Constitution Act work. In that NCRT, that question have been picked. So make sure that you are utilizing that basic sources. So what is democratic form of government? So in this political sense, democracy is a form of government in which rulers are elected by the people in a free and fair elections. So the rulers are elected by people themselves in a free and fair election. So everybody has their own peculiar role in these elections. On universal adult franchise and governed on the basis of certain fundamental rules. Okay, the universal adult franchise means whoever the age of 18 or above can vote in that elections. That's called universal adult franchise. Okay. Civil liberties are guarantees and freedoms ensured by the government of a country to its citizens. So these guarantees are ensured through laws and is managed by legislature, executive and judiciary. So legislature makes the law for the citizens, executive implement the law for the citizens, and judiciary oversees the laws which is constitutionally valid. Okay. After that, civil and political rights are a class of rights that protect individuals' freedom from infringement by governments, social organizations, and private individuals. Civil liberties and political rights form the basis of a democratic system of government. So, in a democratic system of government, civil liberties, and that is a fundamental right given to the citizens by the ruling government, and political rights form the basis of the democratic system of government. So after going through all this information, we are coming here. So we are conclude that we are very sure that the option A is a correct answer. Civil liberties and political rights form the basis for a democratic system of government. Okay. After solving this question, we are moving to next question. Consider the following statements. Ibn Battuta was a contemporary of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Al-Biruni accepted that social divisions were not unique to India, but disapproved the Indian notion of pollution. Okay. Ibn Battuta. Okay, so there are three personalities given here. Ibn Battuta, Muhammad bin Tughlaq, and third one is Al-Biruni. So we should know that these three important personalities during the medieval Indian times. Okay. So before solving this question, if you go through 2019 prelims question paper, there was a question similar fashion question in this manner. So question is about Saint Nimbarka. He was a contemporary of Akbar, and Saint Kabir was greatly influenced by Sheikh Ahmad Srihindi. So there were four personalities given. So we can infer that we should really about this important personality from our basic NCRT sources and other important textbooks. Okay, so question is about the correct statement. Here there are four options given. You should find them correct answer based on this formula. We have formulated question about Al-Biruni Ibn Battuta Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Okay, so this question have been modeled. See, if you see this question have been taken from basic source of NCERT. If you go through 12th standard NCERT themes in Indian history part 2 Indian history through travelers. There was a separate chapter, Indian history through travelers. And from that area, this question have been picked. Okay, so before solving this question, we are going to see some information about Ibn Battuta and Al-Biruni. Ibn Battuta, he was a Moroccan traveler. He was from Morocco. Ibn Battuta's book of travels, he made important travels throughout the continents and other areas. So he wrote a book called Rila, which provides extremely rich and interesting details about social and cultural life in the subcontinent in 14th century. So he traveled throughout the Indian subcontinent and wrote about social and cultural life of the people in a book called Rila. It is written by who, Mr. Ibn Battuta. The traveling overland through Central Asia, Ibn Battuta reached Sindh in 1333. Okay, at that time he heard about Muhammad bin Tughlaq and lured by his reputation as a generous patron of arts and letters, set off for Delhi. So he was going through Sindh in 1333. At that time he heard about Muhammad bin Tughlaq, and after that he may gone to meet Muhammad bin Tughlaq, the Sultan, who Muhammad bin Tughlaq was impressed by his scholarship and appointed him the Qazi or Delhi judge of Delhi. So he became Sultan of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, and Ibn Battuta becomes contemporary. Both were contemporaries to each other. Okay. So next, Al-Biruni. Who is Al-Biruni? He wrote a Kitab ul Hind. His travel book is called as Kitab ul Hind. When Sultan Mahmud invaded Wasarim, he took several scholars and poets back to his capital Ghazni. He was one of them. It means when Sultan Mahmud of Ghazni was invading Wasarim, at that time his capital was Ghazni, he was taking some scholars and other poets to his capital, that is Ghazni. At that time he also picked Al-Biruni with him to Ghazni. It was in Ghazni that he developed an interest in India. So when he was staying in Ghazni, Al-Biruni was staying in Ghazni, he developed interest about India to learn about India. Okay. So then he tried to explain the caste system by looking for parallels in other societies. So he wanted in attempt to say that social divisions were not unique to India. So it was prevalent in other Muslim world also. In spite of his acceptance of Brahminical description of the caste system, because why he accepted the Brahminical description of the caste system means, and the caste system was even prevalent in the medieval Indian Islamic countries. So at that time, so he accepted that, but disapproved Indian notion of pollution. So India was a very divisive society at that time. So there was a concept of notion of pollution, purity and pollution concept. So what he thought that he disapproved the notion of pollution, but accepted the Brahminical description of the caste system. So after going through all this information, we are coming back to solve this question. So as we saw in our explanation page, Ibn Battuta was a contemporary of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, that is correct. Al-Biruni accepted that the social divisions were not unique to India, yes, correct, but disapproved the Indian notion of pollution, this is also correct. So question is about correct statement. So both the statements are correct, and the correct answer would be option C. Okay, so we are moving to next question now. Third question. If you read that economic survey, you can clearly, easily attend this question. The economic survey of 2020-21 has highlighted that India's sovereign credit ratings do not reflect the economic fundamentals of India. What would be the likely impact of such downgrade in India's credit rating agencies? When our chief economic advisor released the economic survey for the year 2020-21, at that time he elaborately discussed about this credit rating agencies. Why? Because these credit rating agencies do not reflect the fundamentals of Indian economics. India is a big economy, fifth largest economy. So these credit rating agencies do not reflect the fundamentals of our economic basis. Okay, so based on that, the economic survey highlighted some issues, flagged some issues, and recommended some suggestions. Okay, based on that formula, we have formulated this question. We have picked a question from economic survey. Okay, so before solving this question, if you go through prelims 2020 question paper, there was a question in this fashion. If the RBI decides to adopt an expansionist monetary policy, which of the following would not it do means expansionary monetary policy means RBI want to expand the credit flow into the market. Okay, so what it will do, it will reduce the repo rate so that bank will be able to borrow more from the RBI and they will lend to the customers. So RBI will reduce the repo rate. That is called expansionist monetary policy. Which of the following would not do? Cut and optimize the statutory liquidity ratio. Statutory liquidity ratio means bank have to keep certain amounts in their own account, gold and other hard cashes. So that is called statutory liquidity ratio. So it will cut and optimize. Why? Because so if banks are left with more money in their hand to lend, so they will do this. Question is about not do, so it one will not come. So you can remove option A, C, and option B. So the correct answer would be option B. So without going through statement 3, we can consider. But question is about not do, right? So what it will do means cut and optimize certain liquidity. It will do increase the marginal standing facility. No, it will not do. So cut the message. So the correct answer would be option based on this formula. We have formatted this question. So if we go through our economic survey, India and the sovereign credit ratings. There was a chapter called India and sovereign credit ratings. Economic survey 2020 has highlighted that India sovereign credit ratings do not reflect in fundamental economic fundamentals, and the global agencies should become more transparent and less subjective in their ratings. This is what the economic survey tries to highlight. Okay, in November 2019, Moody's, why? Because it was in news, means in 2019, Moody's had changed its forecast about India's economy from stable to negative. Hence, this downgrade in India's rating was largely accepted on account of number of reasons. What are the reasons why Moody has changed India's economic sovereign credit ratings from stable to negative? Means, according to Moody's, the current downgrade is not entirely on account of COVID-19. Even prior to pandemic, the GDP growth rate was declining. Yes, that is why they have reduced from stable to negative. Inability of government to meet its fiscal deficit target has led to increase in government debt. Yes, it is further expected to increase due to COVID-19. So, because of these reasons, Moody's has reduced India's credit sovereign ratings. Then rising stress in the financial sector on account of higher NPA. This was also a major reason. Weak implementation of economic reforms since 2017 and 18. This is also one important reason. Weak implementation of the economic reforms. What will be the likely impact? Bonds issued by Indian governments are now riskier than before. Why? Because India's market stability is in danger position. So the foreign investor will not invest in Indian bonds. So it will become riskier. Hence, the issue of new bonds by government would have higher interest rates due to risk factor involved. Yes, even though the foreign investor will not invest, somebody can invest, but what they will give option for India is they will increase the interest rate. So it will give risk factor involved in Indian economic fundamentals. This would make the government's borrowings to deal with COVID-19 pandemic costlier. Yes, higher risk factor would lead to increase in FPA outflows and hence rupee depreciation. Yes, this is also correct. Negative outlook on India's rating may lead to another downgrade, taking India's rating to junk status. Yes, this is also one of the likely impact of downgrading this sovereign credit rating agency. So after going through all this information, we are coming back to solving this question. So in the first line, what would be the likely impact? Means the bonds issued by India will become riskier than before. Yes, this statement is correct. The increase in FPA outflows, this is also correct. Rupee depreciation, this is also correct. So the question is about correct statement. So the answer could be option D. D is the correct answer. So we are moving to Next question. Fourth question. Fourth question. This crop is both tropical and subtropical in nature. It grows well in hot and humid climate. Okay. This crop requires temperature range between 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius. It requires an annual rainfall between 75 to 100 centimeter. India is the second largest producer of this crop. Which of the following crop denotes these characteristics? So there are four options given. Option A, cotton. Option B, jute. Option C, sugarcane. Option D, tea. So this question has been taken from our NCERT, India People and Economy book. Very basic question is why? Because if you go through 2020 question paper, there was a question from same book, same concept. Okay, so based on this formula, we have picked a very basic question from these areas. So before solving this question, the characteristic features of got cotton, jute, sugarcane, and tea should be known. Cotton, it grows well in drier parts of black cotton soil of Deccan Plateau. So Deccan Plateau is the largest producer of cotton. It requires higher temperature, light rainfall, or irrigation. 210 first 3 days and bright sunshine for its growth. Yes, this is a climatic condition required for cotton growth. It is a kharif crop. Yes, this is a kharif crop. Why? Because it requires high temperature. So it is a kharif crop and it requires 6 to 8 months to mature. Yes, major cotton producing states are Maharashtra, Gujarat, Tamil Nadu, Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh. These are the Deccan Plateau. Most of the states are Deccan Plateau states. And jute, it is known as golden fiber. Yes, it is also called golden fiber. Grows well on well-drained fertile soils. It grows well in fertile soils in the floodplains. Okay, so where soils are renewed every year. Yes, that is why if you see, jute has been growing in West Bengal, Bangladesh, West Bengal, Odisha, Andhra Pradesh. Why these areas east coast are deltaic areas, that is floodplains. So jute grows well here. High temperature is required during the time of growth. Same like cotton. West Bengal, Bihar, Assam, Odisha, Meghalaya are the major jute producing states. Okay. Then what about sugarcane and tea? Sugarcane, it is a both tropical as well as subtropical crop. So sugarcane is growing both in tropical countries such as India and subtropical countries in European and other countries also. It grows well in hot and humid climate. So it is a annual crop, not kharif crop. It is not a sugarcane, it's not a seasonal crop. With the temperature of 21 degrees Celsius to 27 degrees Celsius and an annual rainfall between 75 to 100 centimeter. Same like cotton, it can be grown on a variety of soils and needs manual labor from sowing to harvesting. Yes, India is the second largest producer of sugar cane only after Brazil. So Brazil is the largest producer of sugar in the world. Second is India. Okay, tea plant grows well in tropical and subtropical climates endowed with deep and fertile well-drained soil rich in humus and organic matter. So tea requires rich humus and organic matters. Tea bushes require warm and moist free climate all throughout the year. Yes, moist free climate all throughout the year. Frequent showers evenly distributed over the year ensure continuous growth of tender leaves. Yes, this is a climatic characteristics of tea. So after going through all this information, we are coming back to solving this question. So if you see, it is both tropical and subtropical in nature. Temperature range between 21 to 27 degrees Celsius. Rainfall between 75 to 100 centimeters. So it is clearly, we can conclude that option C is the correct answer. Sugarcane is the mentioned crop. Okay, moving to next question. In India, illegally imported wild species are confiscated under Customs Act of 1962, CITES provisions, Foreign Trade Policy, Wildlife Protection Act 1972. So select the correct answer. Okay. So if you go through 2020 question paper, there was a question from Wildlife Protection Act, but not exclusive from Wildlife Protection Act. One they have asked is, what is the implication? There are some 6 schedules in the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. So if a particular species is placed in schedule 6, what could be the implication? That was the question. So by following this question, we have formulated that in this question, for our discussion. So before solving this question, if you go through our explanation, recently Directorate of Revenue Intelligence has busted a wildlife syndicate involved in smuggling of exotic macaws from Bangalore. So if you go through newspapers, last year June, July, August, and the world was under lockdown. At that time, there is a syndicate, wildlife syndicate, smuggled a lot of exotic species macaws from Bangladesh. Okay, the exotic birds were identified: hyacinth macaw, pesquet parrot, severe macaw, and horns macaw. Okay, so what are exotic macaws? Macaws are beautiful, brilliantly colored members of the parrot family. Okay. It is a parrot family. It is a bird and a parrot family. Macaw, exotic macaw, native to Central America, North America. In North America, only restricted to Mexico, South America, and formerly in Caribbean area. Most species are associated with the forest, especially rainforest. They are associated with rainforest, but others prefer woodland or savanna like habitats. Okay, so their habitat could be rainforest, woodland, or savanna like habitats. The macaws are protected under sites, with the hyacinth macaw being accorded highest protection. Okay, so next one is provision related to wildlife trade. Illegal wildlife trade. Which are the provisions are related to illegal wildlife trade? Means first one is Customs Act of 1962, which can be read with the sites provisions, and then foreign trade policy, export import of this exotic species. Okay, and then Wildlife Protection Act 1972, which protects the commercial wild animals, animal articles or trophies. Okay, Directorate of Revenue Intelligence works under the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs under the Ministry of Finance. Okay, so after going through all this information, we are coming back to solve this question. So if you go through all these statements, all the statements are correct. Customs Act, sites provision, foreign trade policy, wildlife protection act. So all the statements are correct. Question is a correct answer. So the answer could be option D. All the statements are correct. So moving to next question. With reference to winter diesel, consider the following statements. It has a low pore point and higher saturation rate. It has lower sulfur content. It can be used in temperature as low as minus 30 degrees Celsius. It meets the Bureau of Indian Standards specification of Bharat 6 grade. Which of the statements given above is correct? So question is about correct statement. Question from the topic winter diesel. Okay. So if you go through 2020 question paper, there was a question about carbon nanotubes. They can be used. They can be made, they can be used, sorry, they can be used, the carbon nanotubes are viable. So the question is about the usage of what are the benefits and use of carbon nanotubes and how it can be made and whether their important characteristics, whether they are biodegradable or not. So based on this formula, we have formulated this question for winter diesel. Why? Because if you go through the newspapers, recently Indian Oil Corporation has sought approval for the use of winter diesel by armed forces for operations in high altitude areas like Ladakh. So winter diesel is specifically designed for the usage in the areas of high altitude regions. Why? What is winter diesel? It is a specialized fuel specifically for high altitude region and low temperature regions such as Ladakh, where ordinary diesel can become unusable. Why in this high altitude region ordinary diesel become unusable means? In regular diesel fuel contains paraffin wax. It has a one common called paraffin wax, which is added for improving viscosity and lubrication. So the paraffin wax was added in the regular diesel for the viscosity and lubrication. At low temperature, the paraffin wax, in low temperature, waxes will thicken. At the higher temperature, it will thaw. Okay, so thickens or gels and hinders the flow of fuel in the car engine. That is why this special type of fuel has been developed for the high altitude region. That's called the winter diesel. It also meets the Bureau of Indian Standards specification of Bharat 6 grade. Yes, this is correct. Low viscosity. It has low viscosity. Why? Because the idea is to maintain low viscosity by enabling the fuel to remain fluid in such conditions. Okay, that is why it provides low viscosity. Next is low pore point. It has a low pore point. Pore point means as low as minus 30 degrees Celsius. That is, what is low pore point means? It is the temperature below which the liquid loses its flow characteristics. And higher sedan rating means it is an indicator of combustion speed of diesel and compression needed for ignition. Low sulfur content, it would lead to lower chemical deposit in engines and better performance. So these are the important characteristics of inter diesel: low bore point, higher sedan rate, lower sulfur content, and low viscosity. Okay, they also means BAS for 6th grade. Okay, so after going through all this information, we are coming that we can conclude that all the statements are correct. So it has a lower point, a higher sedan rate, it has lower sulfur content, it can be used in temperature as low as 30 degrees minus 30 degrees Celsius. It means BA6 grade. So all the statements are correct. So the answer could be option D is the correct answer. Okay, moving on to next question. Consider the following pairs: caves, deity, Ravanapadi, Lord Shiva, Undavalli, Lord Vishnu, Mahakala, Lord Buddha. So which of the pairs given is correctly matched? So question from cave associated deity. So if you go through 2018 question paper, there was a question about craft and their associated heritage, state associated state. So in this fashion, we have formulated caves. Why? Because UPSC has shifted from conventional area to these peripheral areas. So we have shifted our focus from main areas to these cave-like architectures. So before solving this question, we are going to see some information in the explanation page. Ravanapadi cave, the rock cut Hindu temple of Ravanapadi in Aipur, Karnataka. So Ravanapadi cave in Aipur, Karnataka, it is a rock cut Hindu temple and was made during the 550 AD. The icon which is used to the captain during the rule of Chalukya. Okay, so Ravanapadi cave is in Aihole, Karnataka. It was the capital during the reign of Chalukya dynasty. It is a rock cut Hindu temple. So Ravanapadi is a cut in rock and Lord Shiva is worshipped in the temple. So Ravanapadi cave is associated with Lord Shiva. Okay, Undavalli cave. The Undavalli caves date back to 7th century BC. It is very old and are prime example of rock cut architecture. The caves offer a unique perspective into ancient religious practices. Okay, so the cave, why? Because the caves are popular for its huge monolith of Lord Vishnu. So Undavalli cave is associated with Lord Vishnu in the Hindu deity in the reclining posture. The main cave is prime example of Gupta architectural style. So I hold that is Ravanapadi cave is associated with Chalukya and this one is Undavalli cave is associated with Gupta architecture style, which concentrated on primitive rock cut monastery cells. Mahakala cave is also known as Dungeshwari cave temple. It is associated with Lord Buddha. That it is believed that Lord Buddha mediated in 3 caves before he continued his journey to Bodh Gaya. That is why it holds an important position in the Indian history. The caves here also feature Buddhist shrines, which are called Sujata Stan by the people. So after going through all this information, we are coming to solve this question. So Ravanapadi cave is associated with Lord Shiva, Undavalli cave is Lord Vishnu, Mahakala cave is associated with Lord Buddha. So question is about correctly matched. All the pairs are correctly matched. So the answer could be option D. Moving on to next question. Question 8. Which among the following key flagship schemes being currently run or managed by Department of Financial Services? So there are 3 schemes. Which of the following key schemes have come under the Department of Financial Services? Stand Up India, okay. Stand Up India, Pradhan Mantri Vaya Vandana Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana. So question is about correct statement. So there are 4 options given here. We should find the correct one. So this question has been inspired from the prelims 2019 question paper. If you go through this question, Atal Innovation Mission is set up under. So which is the, there were 4 options given under which institution or which ministry this Atal Innovation Mission comes under. So based on the, by inspiring this formula, we have formulated that question. Before solving this question, we are moving to see some explanation about this on this key flagship schemes. Important key flagship schemes being currently run or managed by Department of Financial Services are Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana to ensure comprehensive financial inclusion of all households in the country by providing universal access to banking facilities, every household, financial literacy, access to credit and insurance and pension facilities. So, universal financial inclusion is the main objective of Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana. Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana to create a social security system for the poor and underprivileged in the age group of 18 to 50 years by providing a renewable life insurance. So, Pradhan Mantri Jeevan Jyoti Bima Yojana is for the insurance cover. Pradhan Mantri Suraksha Bima Yojana, this is also insurance cover, but for accident insurance cover. Okay. Next Yojana is Atal Pension Yojana to provide social and financial security to people in their old age. So, old age financial security scheme. Atal Pension Yojana is the old age financial security scheme to make regular saving during their productive years. Okay, Pradhan Mantri Mudra Yojana to encourage entrepreneurs and small business units to expand their capabilities operations to ensure over indebtedness and provide formal system of credit. That is what the objective of Pradhan Mantri Mudra Yojana. Okay. Next one is Stand Up India Scheme. Stand Up India Scheme is to facilitate the bank loans between 10 lakh and 1 crore to at least one scheduled caste and one scheduled tribe borrower and at least one woman borrower per bank branch, setting up a greenfield enterprise, not a brownfield, only greenfield for one SC or ST when the range is 10 lakh to 1 crore. Okay. Pradhan Mantri Vaya Vandana Yojana to provide senior citizens with a regular pension during the time when there is a fall in interest rate. So, required a regular pension without any fall in the interest rate. So, after going through all this information, we are coming back to solve this question. So, as we saw in the explanation page, all the schemes are comes under the purview of Department of Financial Services. So the answer could be option D. All the statements are correct. So moving on to next question now. Which one among the following countries is not a member of G7 or group of 7? So there are four options. Option A, Russia, Canada, Japan and Italy. So if you go through 2020 question paper, there was a question from membership of G20 countries. So there were four countries given in each option. You should find the correct group from this among the four options. Okay, so before solving this question, we are going to see some explanation about the G7. So recently Donald Trump had called for the existing group of 7, that is G7 club, a very outdated group of countries, and he wanted to include India, Russia, South Korea and Australia in this group. So this was recurrently in news for at that time. So Trump wanted to include India, Russia, South Korea, Australia into the G7 club because he thought that G7 became very outdated group of countries. So then it becomes important to see about G7 groupings. G7 or group of 7, it is also called as group of 7. The G7 or group of 7 are Canada, member countries are Canada, France, Germany, Italy, Japan, the United Kingdom and the United States. So Canada, Italy and Japan are members. So now Russia is not a member. It is an intergovernmental organization that was formed in 1975 by the top economists of the time as an informal forum. It is not a formal forum. It is an informal forum to discuss the pressing world issues. Okay. Canada joined the group in 1976 and the European Union began attending it in 1977. So European Union also attended its G7 meeting. So after going through all this information, we are coming back to solve this question. So as we saw, Canada, Japan and Italy are the members of G7. So the Russia is not a member of G7. So the correct answer would be option A. Moving on to next question. World Investment Report is released by United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, World Bank, World Economic Forum, United Nations Office for Disaster Risk Reduction. So what is World Investment Report and who publishes this report? So if you go through 2016 question paper, there was a similar fashion question. In every year UPSC asked question from this indices or report. So it becomes very important to have a look at it. Okay. So United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, UNCTAD, publishes World Investment Report. So World Investment Report was released by UNCTAD. World Bank releases Ease of Doing Business Index, World Development Report, Global Economic Prospect Report, Remittance Report, Universal Health Coverage. Okay. World Economic Forum publishes Travel and Tourism Competitiveness Report, Global Competitiveness Report, Global Energy Architecture Performance Index Report, Global Environment Performance Index, Inclusive Development Index, and Gender Gap Index. Okay. Gender Parity Index is released by UNESCO, but Global Gender Gap Index is released by World Economic Forum. United Nations Office for Disaster Risk Reduction, UNISDR, releases Global Assessment Report. So Global Assessment Report released by UNISDR, but Global Investment Report released by UNCTAD. So after going through all this information, we are coming back to solve this question. So the World Investment Report is published by option A, United Nations Conference on Trade and Development, that is UNCTAD. So here we are summarizing our 13th session from polity, what we have discussed about the democratic system of government, what are the basis for the formation of democratic system of government, which we saw in the first question. Next is about some important personalities, Ibn Battuta and Al-Biruni. And then from economic survey 2020-21, that is credit rating agencies and their effects on Indian economy. And then I am from geography, crops in India, that is about sugarcane. And from environmental perspective, we saw some illegal violent trade and the associated laws which governs this illegal trade. And then winter diesel from science and technology, caves and deities from heritage and culture, caves and associated deities, and then key flagship schemes from schemes and social issues, G7 members from international relations, and World Investment Report from indices and reports. So we have covered very diverse topic from this session. Okay. So make sure that you are going through all these basic information and basic sources for the basic concept clarity. So make sure that you are utilizing best out of it. If you have any query, any questions, please raise your doubts and queries. We are very glad to solve all your doubts and queries. Okay. Thank you.